One of the really important aspects of Dr. Winter's life and this global outreach program is we should always appreciate the background of Dr. John Moe. John Moe is the father of scoliosis. He was the founding member of the Scoliosis Research Society. And he, together with a lot of other wise men, founded the Scoliosis Research Society. Now, amongst all this group of old wise men was a young, youthful, towering giant, Bob Winter.
Dr. Moe simultaneously apparently sensed my interest in scoliosis and asked me to come and help him at Gillette. And it was a great honor to have that invitation, so I jumped at that. In 1964, the South American Orthopedic Society, they met every 3 years, and the conclusion of their meeting was that they were doing really badly in scoliosis treatment in South America. And they came to the conclusion they had to invite some guru, some real expert, to come and to South America and travel around and see the situation and tell them what to do. And they picked Dr. Moe. He was invited back for the follow-up trip. But they wanted him to stay for 3 months. They wanted him to do clinics and surgeries and lectures. Well, he was chairman of the department. He couldn't spend 3 months there. So he said, I'll bring a young assistant along. And that was me. I was running the show. I was only 33 years old. And trying to tell these older professors what to do about patient care and having patients get the best that there is available. We had a girl that came out of the slums of Sao Paulo, terrible curvature of the spine, 130 some degrees. She was going to die. So we did this big surgery on her. But the problem was, you know, you go down there for 3 months or 2 months or whatever, and you don't know the result of the surgery, you know? And it was so heartwarming when Dr. Moe and I went back for the 20th reunion of our trip. They brought in several of the patients that we'd operated on 20 years before, and she was one of them. Now, she and I had a problem because I didn't speak Portuguese, and of course, she didn't speak English. And so we couldn't communicate, you know? And this frustrated her so much that she told the nuns that ran the school at the Crippled Children's Hospital there, she wanted to learn English. So when she came back 20 years later, she brought her husband, her two kids, and speaking to me in beautiful English. And I said, oh, that's wonderful. Well, what do? You know, you're a mother, I could see that. Oh, she said, I'm a translator at the American Embassy. I thought, that's it. I couldn't give you a better example.
The thing that he has also left me with is the fact that he goes and spreads the knowledge about spinal deformity surgery all over the world. I do the same thing, and I know it's because I've had an example of what he's done that I am following in his footsteps. The other thing I also see is the ripple effect in the fellowships that have been established by fellows that have gone through our program and the people they have trained, keeping up the same ripple effect.
Very important for us to remember the legacy and tradition. And that's what this fellowship is going to allow us to do, is to maintain that legacy of treating spine deformity patients. Ultimately, what we're really trying to do is to do further global outreach. We want to memorialize the efforts that he made in his life. This is more about setting up an endowment and a fellowship program that is going to benefit patient care everywhere else. Dr. Winter is the vehicle to further that.